it's Jessie V. And today we're gonna be talking about black cats. So of course I had to wear my Black Cat Club shirt, and we're doing this video because for some reason there is so much superstition around black cats, especially around Halloween. And I was able to find so much creepy information that I had to do a whole video on it. And I just wanna preface before I get into this video, I have nothing against cats. I've definitely been more of a dog person growing up because I've had some bad experiences with cats, but no doubt they're adorable, they're cute, and if you have one, that's awesome. And if you have a black cat, that's awesome. Just because people have these superstitions about them doesn't mean they have to be true. But yeah, cat lover, dog lover, I love you all. And before we get into this video, I just want to mention one more time, I know you guys know by now, but I do have a new Halloween backdrop behind me. If you would like to win it, all you have to do is follow my TikTok account. It's called Official Jessie V. And if I see your name popping up a lot throughout the month of October, just liking stuff, commenting on stuff, I will choose you as the winner. And obviously, as you know, you have to be subscribed to this channel and have your notification bell on. And with all of that being said, let's get into this video about black cats. At some point in time, the image of a black cat with glowing eyes has become intimately associated with the Halloween holiday. Way back in the day, people used to think that black cats were extremely evil. And what's so sad and horrifying to me is that they would usually be sacrificed on October 31st. I am so glad they don't do that anymore. In the Middle Ages, it was a commonly held belief that witches could disguise themselves as black cats so they could roam freely, causing havoc and spying on people without them knowing. It's said that the story began when a black cat was seen running into a house thought to be inhabited by a witch. So because of all of those rumors, these cats began to be associated with witchcraft and evil. In fact, many witches in Europe were burned at the stake with their cat beside them because they just associated them together. And many superstitions and myths about black cats still exist to this day. So I'm gonna tell you some of the most common misconceptions and myths and legends about them. People say it is bad luck for a black cat to cross your path. And honestly, any animal back in the day that had like black feathers, black fur, or anything dark associated with them, like ravens and crows, they were associated with death. So people were extremely afraid of them. People say to never turn your back on a black cat or you will be cursed. People also say that if a black cat ever jumps on your bed while you're extremely ill, that means that you will die soon. If a black cat walked onto a ship and then walked off again, the ship was doomed to sink on its next voyage. And people also say that if the cat stays on the boat the whole trip, it's good luck. In Appalachian folklore, it says that if you have a sty on your eye and you rub it with the tail of a black cat, it should make the sty go away. But to me, that just sounds like really unsanitary. They also say that if you find a single white hair on the fur of your black cat, it's a very good omen for you. In England's border countries and southern Scotland, a strange black cat on the front porch brings good fortune. And in other parts of England, a bride will have luck in her marriage if she receives a black cat as a gift. So you can really see how many superstitions there are, and that's not even all of them. But they stem from being really bad luck to really good luck. So which one is it? Black cats, in truth, are far from bad luck and evil. They are loving family friends just like any other cat. And sadly, there has been this phenomenon known as black dog syndrome. Black dog syndrome refers to a pattern that many shelter workers and adoption volunteers have noticed over the years. Adopting black dogs and cats into homes, no matter what time of year it is very difficult. And here are some theories as to why people think black dogs and cats don't get adopted very often. The first reason people think is that they don't photograph as well on adoption sites and flyers. The second reason is it is hard to discern their facial expressions and grow attached to their personality. Then it says there are negative associations with the movies and the media, like I'm just talking about right now. And it also says that people are superstitious. And that's horrible. Imagine not being adopted because people have these like preconceptions of you that aren't even true. So let's shut those down right now. Please adopt. Doesn't matter what color the animal is. I actually wanted to talk about the cats in ancient Egypt because they were treated so differently. The ancient Egyptians honored cats of every color. Cats were mighty and strong and held sacred. Family cats were adorned with jewelry and fancy collars and even had pierced ears. And if a cat died back in in that time, the entire family would go into mourning. And then they would send the cat off to the next world with this huge ceremony. So for thousands of years, the cat held a position of divinity in Egypt. So let's talk about black cats and modern Halloween. Around the time of World War II, when the American tradition of Halloween as trick-or-treat time really got underway, cats became a big part of the holiday decoration. This time around, however, they were considered a good luck charm. A black cat at your door would scare away any evil critters that might come a-calling. And this kind of reminds me of how jack-o'-lanterns actually are supposed to scare away any evil spirits. Now, growing up, my family actually had this black cat decoration that would go out on our front lawn every single year. And I'm pretty sure the reason we had it and used it constantly was because this decoration specifically was like passed on through the family for 80 years. So it's kind of like a family heirloom cat decoration. But I don't think we ever used it for like superstitious reasons. And what I found out through research, which blew my mind, was that people were being warned that if you have a pet black cat, to keep them indoors on Halloween, just in case there are any Halloween pranksters prowling about. If they don't like black cats, a lot of the times they will do something terrible to them. Because honestly, there are some very evil people in this world that don't care about the life of animals or even humans. But let's move on to something lighter and talk about some of the most famous black cats in media. First, we have Salem from Sabrina the Teenage Witch. We also have Sylvester from Looney Tunes. We have Felix the Cat. We have Binks from Hocus Pocus. We have the cat from The Cat in the Hat, but he's sort of black and white. We have the cat from Coraline, which we all love. We have Lucifer from Cinderella. And I just want to say, I didn't even realize his name was Lucifer. Like, why would they name him that? And then we have Catwoman, which I don't know if she really counts in this list. But it just shows you that black cats really have been celebrated in movies and TV shows. And lastly, I want to talk about this sort of eerie story. It's called The Visitor. This is about a girl who used to babysit her neighbor's cat. It was this elderly woman who had a very old black cat, but it was so friendly and cuddly. And one day, it unfortunately passed away, and this girl was just so heartbroken. But on the night he died, she looked out her window at night and saw him sitting on the fence watching her, except it had pure white glowing eyes. And every night going forward, she would see him out there. It was almost as if he was protecting her, but she just couldn't get over how eerie he looked with those white eyes. And this wasn't a creepypasta, this was like a true story that someone told online. And I've actually heard a lot of stories about how people's pets like come and watch over them after they've passed away, which I find really sweet, but also pure white glowing eyes is kind of scary too. Anyways, guys, those were all of the creepy and weird things that I found about black cats online. If you have any other really cool facts, definitely comment them down below. But like I said, these are all just superstitions that are not meant to be taken seriously. A black cat is just like any other cat or animal, deserves love, deserves kindness, and I truly don't believe they're gonna curse you in any way. I just thought this video would be fun for Halloween just because black cats are associated with this time of year. But anyways, before I get going, don't forget, if you would like to win this new Halloween backdrop behind me, give the official Jessie V TikTok a follow and just be active on there. And yeah, I love you guys so much and I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!